Thanks for joining us on this Saturday afternoon, where qualifying is about to start here in Austria. So sit back and enjoy the afternoon session. What kind of setup will drivers be looking for around here? It's got a fair mixture of demanding corners. Is it all about finding the sweet spot in handling balance?
It's easy to make your car quick in a straight line, you just take all the downforce off. But when it comes to a track like this, you really need a bit more of a compromise. The main focus here is carrying speed through the fast-flowing corners, but you still don't want to be a sitting duck on the straight.
Qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Areno, Verstappen and Daniel Ricciardo. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow where we'll be live with all the action. And until then, it's goodbye.
Hi, guess who? I've seen the team's expectations for the race, so I thought I'd pass them on and wish you luck. Take care.
Austria, traditional home of many great things. Apple strudel, Mozart, Niki Lauda, oh, and of course, one of the finest high-speed racetracks on the planet. We're right in the thick of the season now, and the championship battle is hotting up. But if there's any race that stands to rip up the form book, it's this one. The Red Bull Ring then, 700 meters above sea level. This tough circuit may only have 9 corners, but they're fast and they're bumpy. It's a true test for any racing driver. We have 2 DRS zones and watch out for overtakes into turn 2 as the uphill entry helps those trying to be the last of the late breakers steam up the inside. Anthony Davidson is alongside me today. It's nice and dry up here in the commentary box. How are you, Ant? Hope you're well. Looking forward to the race?
I'm very well, thank you, Crofty. I forgot my umbrella on the way to the box. I'm a bit soggy, but I'm sure I'll dry out soon enough. It's going to be an interesting race in these conditions. Obviously, you can pretty much throw the form book out the window when it starts raining. And the focus moves away from pure aerodynamic efficiency and more towards the balance of setup and definitely maintaining tyre temperature.
Right, let's be patient going into turn one. We want to be in a good position for the rest of the race. Good luck.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's Renault in pole position then, with Daniel Ricciardo slotting in alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Button, Romain Grosjean, and Gutierrez, Verstappen, Rosberg, Massa, and Fernando Alonso, Magnussen, Hülkenberg, Lewis Hamilton, and Vettel, Raikkonen, Harry Anto, Carlos Sainz, and Daniel Kvyat, Bottas, and Nasser, Marcus Ericsson, and Pascal Wehrlein completes the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Thank you.
another fantastic victory for Renault today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
Here come today's winning drivers, and what a race it was! This is a team that knows success very well in F1, and they're just itching for even more. Congratulations to the Renault team for their excellent win today. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Our current points leader extends their lead at the top of the championship after a very good result here today. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going to go for Sebastian Vettel. People have suggested before that he can't race wheel to wheel, but as he showed today, it's nonsense.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Renault have extended their lead at the top of the standings. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.